Are you looking to accept donations on your nonprofit website? Well, keep watching because today I'll show you how you can quickly add a donations page to your WordPress website, and you can do it painlessly without hiring a developer. We'll be using WPForms, and with WPForms, it will require one of two add-ons, either the PayPal or the Stripe add-on. Both add-ons are included with the Pro and the Ultimate license. First thing you'll want to do is go ahead and head over to WPForms and sign up for their Ultimate or Pro level pricing. And once you do that, you can head over to your account. You can go to our downloads area and download the WPForms plugin itself. I'll download that to my computer. And then you'll want to log in to your WordPress dashboard and be in the back end like this. And we need to install that plugin. So let's head over to our plugins area. We'll click Add New. And from here, instead of searching for a plugin, we want to upload our own plugin. From here, you can either click Choose File and find that location. I have it down here, so I'll drag it and drop it up here and click Install Now. We want to activate the plugin as well. And now we have an area over here that is WPForms. And once you install and activate it, you'll see that you need to enter and activate your license key. So we can click on that, or you can go over to WPForms and under Settings. You can get that license key back over on your dashboard for WPForms. So I'll grab it right here, right click and copy, head back over there, and I'm going to enter it and verify the key. Once we have WPForms set up and installed, let's go over to WPForms add-ons because we want to make sure that we get the PayPal or the Stripe added. I'm going to use PayPal for this video, but you can also install the Stripe add-on down here if you're using Stripe. So we'll click Install Add-on, and then we also need to activate it. In addition to the PayPal or Stripe add-on, you also want to make sure that you have the conditional logic add-on installed. So let's click Install Now. And then we'll also activate that. And I'll show you why that's important in a second. All right, now that that's taken care of, let's go ahead and head over and click Add New. Give it a form name, and you can scroll down, and we've actually already have a donation form template that you can start with. So let's go ahead and create a donation form from here. And what that does is it just brings in many of the typical and popular fields that you'll need. The final thing we need to do is make sure that we set up our payments. And so we'll go to the payments area here. See the PayPal standard. We need to enable that here, add the PayPal email address that you have associated with your nonprofit. We want to go ahead and be in production mode. You can also do a test or a sandbox if you're just testing it out. Here you can select whether it's product or service or donations. And if people want to cancel, you can send them to a canceled URL, basically saying, I'm sorry that it didn't work, you know, and maybe walk them through the process of donating again. Now that everything looks good there, we're all right with that. Now you can either have an empty field like this, but a lot of times you probably know this, but when people are donating, they never know what quite how much to donate. So you can actually help them out by giving them multiple items to choose from. So let's scroll down and look for the multiple items under payment fields. And let's grab that and drag it up here. And now we need to edit this. So let's edit what it says. All right, now that we've created that multiple items, we don't like how that looks here. So let's go ahead and clean this up a little. I'm gonna change that right here under the label. And let's change it to something friendlier to say donation amount. And let them know that this will be $10. This will be $25 and $50. And that's for the people who don't necessarily know how much to add, but say you want to give them the opportunity to enter their own amount. You can click enter amount, keep that zero. And what we're gonna do with that is if somebody clicks on the enter amount field, then we actually want to show this donation amount that they can put in. So let's double click on that so we can edit it. And under conditionals, we want to enable the conditional logic. The idea is we want to show this field if the donation amount is set to enter amount, and that's it. Also want to make sure that the required is not checked because they might just choose one of these others. So we don't want to make that a required field. Now we can save it. All right. After we have adjusted those fields, let's go ahead and make sure that the set under settings that our notifications are set up correctly. By default, it brings in the admin email from the website, but you can change this to whatever email you need these notifications to go to. This is also the email subject, so you can change that. Now that looks good. You also want to make sure that the confirmation looks good for the person who is submitting the donation. You can either create a message right there, or you can redirect them to, say, a thank you page, a very specific thank you page or a confirmation page. So I'm going to keep it with the message. And now we can click our save changes. Finally, we need to add the donation form to our website. So I'm going to go under pages, add a new page. You can name it whatever you want. You can add any of the content that is important to add here. And finally, this add form area, we just click on that, go to the drop down, choose the donation form, and add it here. You'll see this short code, just leave it like that. Once you click publish, then it is good to go on your site. Let's open it up into a new tab, and you see what it looks like here. And now you have a very easy donation form that people can fill out. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.